Hello, welcome back to Let's Play The Whispered World Blind. I'm the RPG chick. This thing's making me laugh with its noises. So yeah, funny thing happened on the way back to the lake, so we can get to the island to talk to somebody. Forget the name. So she could tell us or help us get to Corona to bring back the whispering stone that's stuck in our pet Spot's stomach. So we found this thing.
A strange little fellow. The way he clenches this red Nui egg, he seems to be crazy about it.
We heard that bird before. I wonder if that's from its nest.
Hey, you. Can I have your egg? Yes?
Ooh.
I think that was a no. There. Hey, you. I think that was a... There.
It reminds me of the gremlins before they change into the nasty gremlins.
A strange little fellow. The way he seems to...
So we can do with this thing. Let's meet our friend, Spot.
Look, Spot, a new playmate for you.
About the same size, too. Aww.
How cute. There.
Okay, well, it was cute, but it didn't result in anything here. I'll claw you to pieces.
You wanna swap? He's crazy about this red egg.
I'll whack you with the shovel, then take the egg.
You wanna swap?
Okay. Okay. You want to go in the casket? Maybe I can catch it with the net. I didn't want to trade it. Turtles? I'll blow you up then. So everything is swap. Everything is swapping.
Well, Spot, still feeling hungry for important stones? Exactly. Wipe that stupid grin off your face. I'm still pretty mad at you.
Well, I don't know what to do with this thing, so let's leave it for now. Maybe we'll find something elsewhere. I want to check out this tree. Oh! Those things weren't there before, were they?
Oh dear. Aren't those,
fireflies?
Those, creatures that prey on you in the depth of the forest and lure you into dangerous places. What
Whips?
Are they called again?
Wisps.
Chusky, oracle.
Will-o'-the-wisps.
Oh no, lightning bugs.
They don't lure you into dangerous places, lightning bugs.
Now, what did Shana say again?
Oh, the
Where
light.
The forest is deepest, the chosen one will be guided by light.
Before I do anything else with these, let me see if I can get... Alright, I don't have a... I still don't have a container. Unless I'm going to put it into the petrified hat. Doubt it.
I'm not taking the resin off with that. I get my pockets. I need some...
Yep, some kind of a container.
I'm not taking... I get my... I need...
Yeah, we need a container. Alright, let's talk to these things or something. Loving the game so far, guys. Loving it.
You are light, aren't you? Little lightning bugs. Can you lead the way?
Oh, they went in the hole.
The tree seems to be hollow.
We know this. Oh. Hello?
You are light, aren't you? Can you lead?
They're just gonna go in there again. Well, how do we get in there? Huh. Try to catch him, it does the same thing. We're too big to go in there, lightning bugs.
The tree seems to be hollow. Hello? Nobody home. The hole is too small for my hand. Besides, who knows what nasty little insects live in there. That's too big to fit into the hole. I can't enlarge the hole sufficiently with this.
Yeah, we've tried that.
That's too big to... There must be less dangerous ways to act out my destructive side.
Blow him up! You are no help. You'll die now. Oh. You can't do anything with them, or to them, without them going back in there. We need someone with a magic spell. Let's head to the cave really quick. I was wondering why he just headed over there. I wonder... See, I forgot we had this stuff. If I take a shovel, can I break off the bowl?
Nyeh. Nyeh. Phew. No.
Sounded like Cartman.
I'm not here to connect with... Let's see... No, the web is too strong. I can't cut my...
Okay. Let's head back to the island. Well, the shore. Try to get to the island. Oops.
The water looks down. No.
Yeah, I know. We're supposed to go here.
That's the island where I'm supposed to find Kalida. But how am I supposed to get there?
Swim?
I don't think anyone will hear me if I call out. I don't think anyone will see me if I wave. No thanks. I can't really catch fish with my... No, I can't get... I'm too clumsy.
Anything in our bag of tricks that might help? Doubt it. Can I try to catch another fish?
One fish is enough for now.
Okay. Blow up the lake and just walk across.
I don't think that'd still work when they're wet.
Stab the lake.
There are more important things to do than the dishes.
Dishes?
I'm not good at throwing. Plus, that's way too far.
Talk about dishes.
I can't soften the hat that way.
Huh.
I'm not good at floss.
Are we supposed to soften the hat? Let's head back to the camp, circus camp. Guess what I did? Just for you, because I love you.
What's that you have there? Is that my spare hat?
How can you even think that? This one's made out of stone.
Hmm. You're right, but don't mess with that thing anyway. I'm sure it belongs somewhere certain.
Somewhere certain?
A good clown's hat should be relatively solid, all right. But next time you should try using less starch.
He's just gonna tell us not to mess with him, yeah.
Don't unlike you.
Alright. Let's see if there's anything we can interact in within here, because we haven't been in here in quite some time. We've got a cauldron, we've got a cookbook, we got a frog. And recipes and stuff, draw eyes, bottle.
Unreachable, like so many things.
Get that.
How about it, Spot? Care for some earthworm blood? I thought so. My creation is much too valuable to use in a soup. Actually, everything that's good shouldn't be used in the soup. Unfortunately, Grandpa agrees with that. A downward spiral. Somebody should put an end to his miserable existence. I'd do it myself, but I can't stand the sight of blood. Grandpa even makes soups we have to eat with a knife and fork. But for petroleum soup, you just need a spoon and fireproof clothing. Grandpa even makes... But for... I'd love to. Well, thank you for reminding me again and again.
Oh, no problem at all.
I'm not that suicidal. One small spark. And that'll be it for me. I still want to see Corona before I die. No, it's not the recipe's fault. It's just Grandpa's lack of talent. I'd rather not. It might even work, which is what I fear. And then I'd have to get new supplies of earthworm blood. There's hardly a job more exhausting and less appetizing. I'd rather not. It might even work. Which is what I fear. Then they'll roll all over the trailer floor, and I'll have to pick them up by hand.
Ugh.
Oh, No, it's just...
What else can we do with anything? I'm not gonna do anything with any of this stuff.
It's not winter until replugging Grandpa's bottles appears on my schedule. It's nice to have things to look forward to. I'd love to, but I can't reach it. I'm just... Well, thank you for...
Alright, let's try... Can we use this?
I'd rather not. And then I'd have to get new supplies. It's hard...
I need a bottle.
I'd rather not. Then you'll roll... Yeah. That would look hilarious. Too bad I can't squeeze it through the bottleneck.
Well, can we squeeze through a bottleneck? Not much. Anything new to say?
Hello, Grandpa.
Hello, Ben. Is your hat still too tight?
I'm going to leave.
I'm going to leave.
All right, but be back for lunch.
No, Grandpa. I'm going to be away for quite a while.
Is it because of the new recipe?
No, Grandpa.
Go ahead and tell me. I can take the truth.
Take care, Grandpa. I'm going to miss you.
Aw.
See you later.
Cheer up, Ben.
Hi, Ben.
Oh, what do you want this time?
Oh, cool. Okay, I've definitely got options with this jerk here. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Do you know anything about someone called Shana?
You know anything about someone called Shana?
Shana? I never heard that name. Who's it supposed to be?
That's not important.
Like everything else you do.
Nice. There's been a fight at the shore. Did you see anything?
There's been a fight at the shore. Did you see anything?
A fight? Nonsense. We're a long way from Corona. There are no fights in this region.
But...
curb your imagination. I don't have time for your phantasms.
Did you feel the earthquake?
Did you feel the earthquake?
Well, I certainly did. I dropped all my balls. I hope it doesn't happen during a performance.
What if the earthquake is an indication of the world falling apart? Or the sky crumbling down?
During a performance? That'd be a catastrophe.
Ha ha. You don't fool me. You're just as scared of the end as everybody else.
I'm an artiste. I'm never scared.
Sure. You did say he dropped his balls. You really expect me to believe that you're never scared?
You really expect me to believe that you're never scared?
That's right. Never.
Not even of snakes?
Not even of snakes?
Snakes? Bah. Snakes don't even have claws!
But they have poisonous fangs and constricting muscles that can crush your spine.
Give up already. The bit about the teeth is a reason for caution. But I'm not scared of snakes.
Not even of tigers? They have claws.
Not even of tigers?
Tigers? Tigers only have the one head.
But they're fast and strong. They grab you with their razor-sharp claws and mow you with their teeth as big as sabers.
Just give up, will you? The bit about the teeth and the claws is quite impressive. But I'm not scared of tigers.
Not even of spiders?
Not even of spiders?
Spiders?
No. They don't even have sharp teeth.
But they're poisonous and fast. Some species crawl into your mouth and lay eggs beneath your eyelashes.
Give up already. I'm not scared of spiders.
Not even of the Asgil?
Not even of the Asgil?
Asgil? What's that supposed to be?
Why this goes on? The Asgil are gruesome monsters with pointed fingernails.
The Asgil are gruesome monsters with pointed fingernails.
Fingernails?
Yes, their fingernails are so long and pointed they can scratch out your eyes from several yards away.
Ooh. And what else?
They have pointy spikes.
They have pointy spikes.
Spikes?
Yes. They can spear their opponents with arrow-like poisonous spikes. Some Asgil leave the corpses of their enemies impaled on their spikes as decoration until they rot away.
Ooh, I'm starting to get the picture.
Is he getting scared? The worst thing yet is the pointed horn on their forehead.
The worst thing yet is the pointed horn on their forehead.
A horn?
Yes. As soon as they spotted you, they dash forward instantly. They lower their heads and pierce you before you could even think of escape.
Ooh, those Asgil really don't seem to be the most pleasant fellows, but still, I'm not afraid of them.
I'm gonna go back to this. I'm afraid I might have done something really stupid.
I'm afraid I might have done something really stupid.
Again? What is it this time? Did you break something?
Hard to tell. I believe not really. yet.
In that case, I don't want to hear about it.
But...
Be quiet, will you? Can't you see that I'm practicing?
Yeah, not yet. I don't know if the digestive juices have been released yet. Do you know how I can reach this island in the middle of the lake?
Do you know how I can reach this island in the middle of the lake?
Why there? What's the big idea?
Can't you just tell me how to get there?
It's a long story.
Unnerving brothers who don't practice their human cannonball act don't go anywhere.
Yeah, great. Thank you so very much. Great piece of advice. You think that launching the human cannonball is the answer to everything.
If you don't stop bugging me, I'll launch you somewhere you won't like.
All right, Hune, I won't bug you again for a long time.
Don't make promises you can't keep.
What if we do the human cannonball act and it launches us to the island? Wouldn't that be awesome?
You really expect me to believe that you're never scared?
That's right. Never.
Not even of the Asgil?
Asgil? What's that?
The Asgil are terrifying creatures with sharp claws.
The Asgil are terrifying creatures with sharp claws.
Claws?
Yes, so sharp they can peel the skin from your body
skin.
In mere seconds.
And what else?
He is afraid of something with two heads. He did say that tigers only have one head. He is afraid of claws as well. But let me try these other options. They have 11 eyes.
They have 11 eyes?
11 eyes?
Yes, they stare at you from the shadows of darkness, praying, waiting, calculating, and suddenly they jump forth. You don't have a chance to escape.
Ooh, I'm starting to get the picture.
Even worse are their sharp teeth.
Even worse are their sharp teeth.
Teeth?
Yes, they can bite through your neck in no time. The jaws are strong enough to grind even the strongest bones to mere dust.
Oh, skip that one.
You really expect me to believe that you're never scared?
That's right.
Not even of the Asgil?
Asgil? What's that?
The Asgil are gruesome beasts with giant tentacles.
The Asgil are gruesome beasts with giant tentacles.
Tentacles?
Yes. They grab you with their tentacles until you're unable to move and then eat you alive.
Oh, and what else?
Or I'm starting to get the picture. What if I say I don't know anything else about them?
I don't know anything else about them.
Another one of your stupid phantasms, but instead we just got a weird static sound.
You really expect...
That's right.
Not even...
Ask it. What's that?
I don't know. I've never seen one.
I don't know. I've never seen one.
So, they're just another of your stupid phantasms.
See you.
And don't forget you're a...
I want to try something.
Hi, Ben.
What do you want?
You really expect me?
That's right.
Wow, Ben, you're so much braver than me.
Wow, Ben, you're so much braver than me.
Well, that's not saying much, is it? You're even scared of butterflies.
Well, what do you mean? They spread germs, you know.
Spread germs? I do believe you.
I do believe you.
Well, just take a lesson from me. Always remember, we have nothing to fear but sphere itself.
What kind of a sphere are you talking about?
I don't know exactly. I just read it somewhere. I guess it means a glass sphere.
Ah, you mean it could break and then there'd be splinters and all?
Yeah.
Aha. You really expect...
That's right.
Not even...
Ask it. What's that?
He He is afraid of claws.
The Asgil are terrifying creatures.
Claws?
Yes.
And what else?
He is afraid of two heads.
They have two heads.
Two heads?
Yes. And each head possesses a toxic breath that paralyzes its prey. And while one of the heads eats your defenseless limbs, the other is laughing its cruel and cackling laugh.
Ooh, I'm starting to get the picture.
Now, what's the other thing he's afraid of? The teeth?
Even worse are their sharp teeth.
Teeth?
Yes, they can bite through your neck in no time. The jaws are strong enough to grind even the strongest bones to mere dust.
Ooh, those Asgil really seem to be gruesome creatures. I have to admit, I wouldn't want to meet them in a dark alley.
Huh.
You really expect me to believe that you're...
Well, except maybe those Asgil. Oh, those terrible two-headed monsters with their sharp teeth and their gruesome claws. I get the willies just thinking about them. Ooh.
Is there anything I can do?
Didn't I tell you? Preferably, or take a... Maybe you...
I'd rather do the...
Alright, yeah, I guess we accomplished something. We made him afraid of the Asgil. I have to leave, by the way.
I have to leave.
Huh? What do you mean?
Something. Yeah.
Leave? Bye-bye?
What happened?
Don't
sayonara.
Be silly. I'm
adios.
Fed up with your phantasms. What is it now? Is the world coming to an end again?
This time it's different.
It's the Asgil.
Do me a favor and spare me this nonsense.
I'm leaving anyway.
Yeah. Right.
You know, when I save the world from doom, I'll leave out the spot you're standing on.
See ya.
See you.
Yep. See you. And don't forget, you're a...
Anything else to say, Grandpa?
Hello.
Is your...
Say, Grandpa.
You can ask her whatever you...
Okay. Oh boy. Is there anything you can tell me about the Chasky?
Is there anything you can tell me about the Chasky?
Oh, the Chasky? Well, when I was still wet behind the ears, I desperately wanted to become a Chasky too.
I don't want to become a Chasky.
Ah, the Chasky are the messengers of the king. Brave adventurers were characterized by their cunning and courage.
Their
most outstanding quality is that they never lose their positive attitude, no matter how hopeless their situation might be.
Aha! They're the complete opposite of you, Sadwick.
Thanks, Ben. You're a great help. I think everyone has noticed already.
Yeah, but I thought I'd just say it again.
Don't let him tease you. I'm sure you'd make a great Chasky.
I don't want to be a Chasky. And Ben is right. I'd hardly qualify for the job.
Don't be so hard on yourself. Everybody can change.
I don't want to change, okay?
You should try. It could only be an improvement.
Hey, guy. A and B conversation. What do you know about Corona?
What do you know about Corona?
Corona. The royal residence. The center of the world. I haven't been there for a long time. It's a beautiful place. Like it was taken directly from the pages of a fairy tale. The castle sits majestically on a hill. Its orange roofs shine in golden light. The hill is surrounded by small villages and lush green meadows. High up in the sky, fire dragons chase each other and sheep are frisking in the shade of the trees. The clouds are creamy white. And all the people are smiling. The children that play at the roadside.
That's a lot of detail.
The beautiful farmer's wife who herds the geese to the river. And even the coachman who calls out to you. You better not smoke too much tobacco from that crate there. Those were the days. I wonder how it looks now. People say the end is near.
Can you tell me anything about the Asgil?
I've
only heard rumors about them. Oh, they're a hideous horde of cruel monsters, sure. They dwell underground in caves and crevices. They hate the sunlight. Their leader is called... Lucor. He's a cold-hearted warlord. People say he declared war on the king, but that might only be gossip.
That's just chit-chat. And don't scare the little one. The Asgil are nothing more than a horror story.
So what? My whole marriage was a horror story, and it produced your father nonetheless.
Ha. I thought he believed us.
Thinking about it, your grandmother could have been an Asgil too. She was certainly cold-hearted enough. And her name, Gilzar, is even an anagram. If you realign the letters, it reads Asgil.
But Grandpa. Grandma's name was not Gilzar. It was Ilza.
So why do I have Gilza tattooed on my butt?
I guess you were a little juiced.
You're right. I would have never married in a tattoo parlor had I been sober.
Certainly has a lot to say. Does the name Shana ring any bells with you?
Does the name Shana ring any bells with you?
Shana.
Shana-na.
A long time ago, I was told the legend of an oracle that's supposed to live somewhere in the autumn forest. And I believe her name really was, Hey, are you yawning?
Oh, nope.
I'm sorry. Go on.
You don't seem very interested.
I'm listening. Mm.
Let's see. Oracle. Autumn forest. Yes. And her name was Shana.
And that's the whole story?
Roughly. Yeah. Did it help you?
Well...
No. Any idea how I can get to the island?
No. No, sorry. There used to be no island in this lake.
Islands don't just emerge all of a sudden.
Maybe they do, too. The lake used to be bigger then.
Are you sure you're talking about the same lake?
Of course I am, as sure as I'm standing here.
You're
but
sitting.
Grandpa, you're sitting down.
Just imagine I'm standing. Why should I stress my legs? As long as you have your imagination, I'm not getting any younger, you know. Besides, it's quite chilly out here, and I'm not wearing any skivvies.
TMI, Grandpa. Do you know anything about someone called Kalida?
Do you know anything about someone called... Kalida?
Kalida? No, I don't know anything about a Kalida. I once knew a Kailua. She was the innkeeper of a pub at the Suzal Sea. Her parents named her after a domestic drink.
Kailua, yeah.
Kind of tropical fruit punch. Boy, it was delicious. Always decorated with a little paper umbrella and some fruit. I can never get enough. I often took out the umbrella and all the fruit. So I was able to reach even the trickiest corners with my tongue. Yum, yum, yum.
And your punch wasn't too bad either, right?
Yes, it was quite good. A bit too much lemon for my taste.
Uh-huh, thought so.
Yeah, that had nothing to do with what we asked him. Look it up myself.
You know what? I'll just look it up myself.
Yes. Couldn't hurt. I might still seem quite bright in the head. But sometimes the details get a little mixed up.
See you later.
See you later.
Cheer up, Ben.
His name's not Ben. Alright, thanks for watching. See you next time. Hopefully we'll figure something out. Okay, bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.